Chet Blacksmith, 25, still living in Portland, Oregon. This is my second Road Fools. We're here in beautiful Phoenix, Arizona. I'm really excited to be here.
Right on.
Hopefully we find some good pools to shroud with Kurt and Dakota.
My name is Brad Sims. I'm 22 years old from Indian Head, Maryland. My second Road Fools. I'm looking forward to riding some new spots in Arizona and Cali and wherever else the trip takes us to. So it should be a good time.
Corey Martinez from Decatur, Alabama. We'll be 25 soon and Road Fools 16.
Hey, what's up? My name's Corey Bowen, 26 years old from Brisbane, Australia. Out here on Road Fools in Phoenix. It's good times.
Hi, my name's Rob Wise. I'm 21 years old. I'm from Layton, Utah. I've been out to Arizona quite a few times, but I've never been into Phoenix, so I'm kind of excited to ride all the good spots here.
Hey, what's going on? My name's Anthony Napolitan, 22 years old from Youngstown, Ohio. It's my first Road Fools, and I'm really stoked to be on this trip.
Hi, my name's Dakota Roche, 20 years old from Huntington Beach, California. It's my first Road Fools here in Arizona right now. Really good state to ride for sure. Hot weather, but you know, we're doing it.
Hi, I'm Justin Simpson, 21 years old from Olmsted Township, Ohio. It's my first Road Fools, first time out west riding, so I'm pretty excited.
How's it going? My name's Kurt Rasmussen. I'm 23 years old from Mission Viejo, California, and it's my first Road Fools.
Hey, my name's Morgan Wade. I am 24 years old, still reside in Tyler, Texas. So this is my first real riding trip out this way in dry Arizona. It's gonna be a blast.
Hi, I'm Aaron Ross, 21 years old from Corpus Christi, Texas, and this is kind of my fourth Road Fools.
What's up? I'm Nathan Williams. I'm 20 years old. I'm from Nashville, Tennessee. Really looking forward to the trip. I've never been to any parts of the country that we're going to, so it's gonna be fun.
Hey, I'm Brett Walker, 23 years old from Corona, California, and it's my first Road Fools. Should be good. Let's go get hot and sweaty in Arizona.
All right, day one, showed up the Levi's store for the trip kickoff party. Everyone got some free jeans.
And signed some autographs for some kids.
Pretty fun. Me and Justin came up on some jean jackets. Unfortunately, it's too hot in Arizona to wear jean jackets, but as soon as I get back to Portland, it'll be good.
I scored a sweet free jean jacket. So I'm pretty pumped on that. Can't wait to wear it later in some 90 degree weather.
Simpson. I got one just like it.
We went riding from there. Went and rode Phoenix Street. Went to some industrial park area with a bunch of spots all around it. We'll be right back.
Well, I saw Corey do a backwards lucky grind to 180 out. That was awesome across this channel thing. And then I tried to 360 the channel and almost broke my ankle.
Oh, I might broke my ankle.
I heard it real bad. It cracked.
Dakota thought he broke his ankle, but I don't think he broke his ankle at all. Now he hobbles like a ninja turtle real weird. It's really funny, kind of, but I feel bad for him.
Just twisted my ankle about as bad as I ever had before. Trying to three this stupid gap.
Brad did his crazy ice pick grind. It had to be at least 3 or 4 inches above bar, and he just hopped on it every time like it was nothing. Rob was trying to do this over ice, back over fakie bar, and just dabbed his foot. He's so close, he's getting a little frustrated. I think the heat was getting to him. We ended up just kind of leaving from there, getting kicked out.
Give you 20 bucks for us right now.
Getting pretty hot out here in Phoenix, still here hanging out.
We got some jeans that are shrink to fit when you get them wet, since we got a pool at the hotel. Decided to take a little dip in our clothes. These jeans nice and fit.
My pants are starting to get tight around my crotch. That's how I like it.
We split up into groups.
Smoker Dave took us around and took us to a real cool school.
And Casey Badger took us to this wedge-to-wedge spot. Went to the wedge-to-wedge spot. Anthony decided to tail whip it first, and then he decided to get the helmet and mouth guard on to front flip it.
He did it once and just landed on his butt so hard. Thought he was done. Got up and did it again so smooth. It was perfect.
One of the most craziest things I've ever seen. I didn't even know you could front flip off something like that.
It's unreal. It's like 20 feet and it's only like 3 feet tall. It's crazy.
Pretty much epic.
Sun was going down. Go to this wall ride spot. It's pretty gnarly. Kurt decided he's gonna try it.
I kept saying, there's really no way you can fall in there if you commit to it. You know, like I was real confident. First time I gave it a go, I got on the ledge and I think I looked up at the wall too late.
Bailed, Spider-Man the wall. I thought he was knocked out. Like he hit so hard, didn't move. he didn't really inform us that when he falls real hard, he likes to lay there and like gather his thoughts by not moving.
I got out of here.
Starts to move and he gets up. He's like, oh, I'm fine. And we're like, what do you mean you're fine? And he's like, oh, I just like to gather my thoughts. And everyone's like, tell us next time.
No big deal. So we tried a couple more times and he almost had it, but it got too dark and pretty scary.
Hey, this is day three on Road Fools. Went to Chandler Bike Park. Rode this really sick bikes only park. It was it's definitely 100 degrees there.
Catfish got here today, so the trip should be a lot more childish.
Brad Sims hopped the handlebar high rail into a 7-foot quarter, and it was pretty wild. This is the last time you will sing. Morgan did like this little tiny flare no-hander, but it was no big deal. Morgan Wade did a no-handed flare over the channel, and it was, I didn't see it, but you could pretend like I did, and it was absolutely amazing from what I hear. And then like this little gap people do all the time, but no. Just kidding. It was insane. My sweet, this is the last time you will breathe for me. This is the last time you will sing. We rode the, guess we're gonna call it the cheese grater ditch today.
If you fall down, your arms look like hamburger when you get up.
Bunch of good stuff went down there. Watched Corey Bowen do the best one-handed table I've ever seen in my whole life.
Day three, just going to ride some more. So last night, two bags ended up getting stolen out of the room I was sleeping in. It ended up being Brett Walker's and Corey Bowen's, basically luggage, like with all their clothes and stuff in it. Except for Bowen's actually had his brand new laptop, which is 2 days old.
Two big bags right here. Me, laying down sleeping right there. Of course, just a nightmare. Bowen's laptop, 2 days old, gone.
Well, because of me sleeping.
So Brad and Bowen are going to fly home. We're going to pick them up in a couple days, I guess, once we get down near their area, and then hook back up.
Today's day four. Today we went out to some like baseball field ledges with a rail on top.
Saw Kurt Rasmussen gap to Derek Duster. Yeah, I think that's what it was. He did it so smooth, I think everybody was confused how fast and how smooth he did it. And we were like, wait, what? Dude, he doesn't have to do it again?
Then Rob went ahead and did something pretty crazy, like 180 over a gap to backwards grind a rail. It looked super scary, but he definitely came through and did it. Then from there we went to same ledges, but down the street, and it's like a step ledge, and a lot of good stuff happened there. Then we came back to the hotel and then ended up going to Wright Street all night.
Kurt did a really sweet gap to curve wall ride, an amazing setup.
We're at ASU, and there's some art people outside, and we thought Corey needed wax, so they brought me this and a torch to wax up the dumpster. The torch is sweet. So we started the day off today at these ledges just out in the middle of nowhere.
Turns out it's pretty windy.
Things were just blowing everywhere. There's probably tumbleweeds. And I was just like, this is ridiculous. Like, not even going to try and ride. But apparently people decided that it was a good idea. And they did some tricks that were pretty insane.
Justin decided a little too windy, and so he decided to go get a sleeping bag and a skateboard. Made himself a little sail, and I didn't even think it was gonna work, but next thing I know, he's hauling ass down the street.
Mom.
And then we drove into the desert further and further. I thought they were dragging me out there for not getting any clips.
And we pulled up to Ray's, and it was awesome. He had a vert ramp, an awesome mini, trails with like dirt quarters, and insane dog. It was just an awesome scene.
The trails were canceled out. It was too windy. It was like a sandstorm out there. Wind would just be blowing in. Dust would be coming across the ramp.
I don't know if you can hear, but I got like sand in my mouth from the wind blowing it in my face.
In the same house all my life, I sit on this bar stool and watch the same fights. I'm sick of the same damn view, the broken down school. Blind man might see the beauty, but yeah, I got some news for you. I don't need no anymore. I don't need to go anywhere. 36 been flooded for the better half of the year.
You could actually play Guitar Hero underneath the ramp in a little house.
One of my tendons in my knee has tendonitis, and it doesn't like me sometimes. Ooh. And then sometimes it likes me, so everything's all good.
Tell us about the 69 game.
The 69 eyes. If I look at you like this, you have to do a backward somersault. Or if I look at Morgan Wade, he's got to do a backward somersault like he just did right there. Can we get that backward somersault? That's all you need to know about the backward somersault game.
That was good.
Got any more tough questions for me?
And we just hung out. It's kind of like a big jam session.
Crazy good ramp setup. A vert ramp over there. Tornado. Lots of dust.
My dream will come true. That train will come running through.
We definitely got good hospitality from Ray. He ended up buying us pizza, bringing out some drinks and water, and making sure everybody was having a good time. He had the ramps lit. Like, he definitely made it real nice for us to ride there. So, thanks, Ray.
I don't need to know anymore. I don't need to go anywhere. 36 been flooded for the better half of the year.
Morgan
decided to try a new trick that I think he might have invented. 360 downside hand plant to fakie. The first couple tries, it looked like he was getting really close. It was so gnarly. He was just taking it and getting back up, but it didn't work out for him. Finally got out of Phoenix today and drove down like an hour and a half to Tucson.
So Kurt had a friend down here in Tucson that he took us to a couple of the ditches. First ditch was a really scary wall ride, like real big bank to wall. A couple of the guys were riding it.
After the first ditch, we went to the second ditch, and we showed up. We just rolled right into this neighborhood. It was just a normal afternoon, and then all of a sudden, the Etnies rig is in your neighborhood.
There was like a complete mullet family
hanging out around like a brand new yellow Corvette. It was sweet.
Just around the corner there was a ditch with a good hip.
Right. We could do it all and it all go faster. Things could multiply at appalling rates. Then we lose our heads and we still go faster, even on our birthdays.
Some crazy locals just like from all the houses that just started flowing to where we were.
There's even some local kids there watching us shred. They wanted to race Brad, and Brad ended up beating the little kid, surprisingly.
One of the sketchy local girls that was definitely missing a chromosome or two. Justin did this huge 360 out of the ditch over a fence and like right in front of her, and she had no idea what to think.
Yeah, I decided to take this challenge of bunny hopping over a ghost road bike. It seemed like a good idea, like the day was going really well.
So we tried it a couple of times.
Came up a little quicker than I expected.
And just clipped. She took it so bad.
What'd you think of that?
Yeah.
Sun was a little bit in my eyes. I'm not going to make excuses, but
it's always things like that that get people really hurt, so I'm sorry to Justin.
Catfish is a dumbass. It's right there.
But that was funny, so holler at your girl. Find that chromosome. And we all rearrange. All right, we could do it all and it all go faster. Things could multiply at a falling rate. Then we lose our heads and we still go faster.
I watched Brad Sims jump over Rob Wise like it was nothing. Nathan, I don't even know how he can hop that high, but he can get over anything.
Last night, me and Morgan broke off from the crew to head west to Corona, California, where we're meeting up with Corey Bowen and Brett Walker so they can continue on the trip with us. But right now, we're at Lonnie Paxson's trail, so let's get the session going.
Smile that I've been faking. Upside down, it's a frown, so please.
locals took us to a pool that they knew about. It's permission pools owned by a lady who doesn't want to water it anymore. So she let some local kids that ride BMX have the pool, and they emptied it and let us ride it.
It was just sweet, like looked like some random setup, like abandoned pool, but it was actually in the back of their house. So like it was real rad to just like hang out. Like you know you're not gonna get busted and just kinda ride and have fun, and it's kinda like a jam thing. This is how we kiss.
This is how we kiss. I don't know, it was real nice of those guys to let us ride their pool. Definitely good hospitality in Tucson for us. Thanks, guys. So we decided to make one last stop at another school here in Tucson, Arizona before we went to the hotel.
Justin Simpson, signature swan dive, ladies and gentlemen.
Justin Simpson pedaling full speed at the ledge, ate it real bad. That's all you can say about it. Aaron Ross definitely shut that spot down. I don't even know what he did. It was crazy. And he's so wild. He's always burping and spitting the whole time he's riding. He's like up the stairs, down the stairs. And then he's talking. He's like talking the whole time. The only time he's not talking is when he's actually riding up the ledge. Watch the setup of Rob Wise grinding this rail to gap over the fence.
Ridiculous. It was awesome.
Today we drove for 8 hours in the rig to San Diego.
Bacon and cheese crickets.
That sounds disgusting.
Yeah, I know. That's why I bought it.
The trip was pretty fun. There's definitely a rap jam between some Eminem, Lose Yourself, and the music. The moment you want it, you better never let it go. So we've been playing this game for the last 4 days or so.
If you use the word M-I-N-E.
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 Then you have to do 10 push-ups.
On the spot, wherever you're at, doesn't matter. The whole goal is to try and trick anyone you can to say this word.
I've already done 20 today.
Yeah, I probably did 70 or 80, maybe 100.
I just did mine.
Push-ups.
You're gonna be buff after this trip.
Stu didn't want to play, but he agreed to play for 24 hours, and he did over 100 push-ups, I think.
I watched Rob Wise do 50 push-ups today while we were driving. He just kept racking them up.
He was in pain. He was not liking it.
Push-up fools. Oh, wait.
We're in San Diego. This is where Gary Young lives. Today he was coming to show us around to ride some street all day. He gets here, parks his car in the parking lot.
These three young ladies had pulled out and backed into Gary into his nice BMW M Series. Pretty much wrecked one of the panels. His front door wouldn't even open.
Luckily it's a nice big car, so maneuver in here.
Sad to say, it's funny, but not funny at all. But Gary laughed it off.
What are you doing?
Once everyone pulled themselves together, rode San Diego Street.
Gary took us around, showed us some of his local spots.
Yeah, it was pretty rad. Got to go to some schools.
So we found this rail, and I was sweating it really, really hard because I haven't done a rail in a really long time.
It's been a while for him, but he was pretty serious about getting it done.
Everybody was like really like supporting me and like telling me to just man up and do it.
He's got it. He's just being grandpa, you know?
So we were sitting around watching and that, and he had his run-ups and stuff, and then built up enough guts, you know, to go for it. And
so the first attempt didn't go that good.
Took one good digger, but I got straight back up and went up there and fired it off. He pulled it pretty clean. I was so psyched for him.
But now, Grandpa got street moves.
Catfish, rail boss, watch out.
Psych.
But I don't know, man. It was a good little day. Corey did an amazing line on this rail.
Kurt did an alley wall ride. They actually like rode backwards across the wall with a free coaster. He doesn't even own a free coaster, but he put one on. He made some magic work.
So we went to this pretty gnarly rail. Basically got out of the car. Nathan fired out this overgrind on a 21 stair rail first try.
Justin finishing off the night with a banger. This quick little manual to a decent gap to rail to hop over. The kid's a warrior, so I was psyched to see him pull it and get it done, and it was a good way to finish the day. So yeah, Road Fill 16's coming to an end right now.
We're in San Diego at the Levi's store, and it ended with a demo pretty much just in front of the store right on the sidewalk.
Tons of people came out. This dude, Dan Hubbard, brought out his ramps.
And pretty much had two mellow quarter pipes of the street spine just set up right outside the front door of the Levi's store.
I think we were riding on a box jump lip and a box jump landing, so couldn't really like, air out of it. Super small spine.
It's pretty cool because one of the quarters backed up to the pillar. And on this day, you know, security couldn't shut it down. We were allowed to put marks all over it. It was pretty sweet, man. We got away with murder just ripping that wall apart.
People that own the building probably aren't going to be too psyched on all the tire marks and chunks taken out of it.
Yeah, so the demo ended up being pretty sweet. A lot of good stuff went down. You could swear, yeah, you could fly.
Pretty wild, the events that were going down during the thing and after and in between.
And I don't know, there's some pretty weird people, interesting characters cruising around the mall.
Kids, this is why you should not do drugs.
What? Tell all the people out there what you think about road pools. Can it cost you that? No way!
I was a Del Mar Ferry Scout! That black guy came up 100 keys and went through the elf with the front doors unlocked.
I can't even get that wild.
It's been my first trip and it's been real good. Had some ups and downs, you know. Stuff got stolen midway through the trip, so I had to head home for a couple of days. I don't know, all in all, man, I've had a great time. Met a couple of new riders that I've never hung out with before. It's just been great, man. Thanks.
It's been a good trip. Rode bikes a lot. I spent a lot of time on the ground, a lot of time in pain, a lot of time doing push-ups.
A lot of push-ups were done. I'm pretty sure 1,000 push-ups were done.
I know the trip was amazing. A lot of crazy riders, a lot of crazy spots. So everybody was awesome hanging out with.
All in all, the trip was good, even though all my stuff got stolen again. It was a real good trip, and you know, do it again in a heartbeat.
This dude showed up in a Lincoln with hydraulics, catfish hopped in shotgun, then he disappeared. Didn't know if he was going to make it back.
You never seen a car on three wheels before?
Today, I got to ride in a Lincoln Town Car with hydraulics, a Cadillac Sedan DeVille with hydraulics, and a limo full of Mexican children celebrating a 15th birthday. So it's nice to know that all of my preconceived notions of California were not let down on this trip.
I had a lot of fun this trip. Definitely saw some funny things, watched some really amazing bike riding. This trip definitely shows me how crazy bike riding has gotten.
Few stories out from the Levi's store. There's a salon right there. Yeah, Catfish rolls in and he organizes this free manicure.
Today has turned out to be the best day of my life.
He'd been talking about having his nails done the whole trip, but he finally did it.
I'll be the first rider with a nail sponsor, Rocco's Nail Care.
I got full treatment just by hanging out. Got a full shampoo and condition, a head massage. All this while guys are still riding the ramp and stuff, so can't complain whatsoever.
I hear like the music going on. I look down and like the demo started, and then everybody makes a big deal because Catfish is late for the demo because he's getting a manicure, but whatever.
Catfish is probably one of the best announcers.
Catfish!
He gets the crowd going, he really does. I think people really like it, and I think it psychs everybody up and it psychs out the riders.
There's a lot of young ladies out here that want to see you move that thing over that ramp. Think we can get you out here one more time?
So the trip's over, it's been really fun.
Nathan, come on, get out here. The kids want to see you. Are you telling the kids no? Is that what it is? You're going to sit there and tell the kids no, Nathan. Can we get you out here, Nathan, just for one foot jam? Now she said, what a ripoff. Nathan Williams getting called out.
There's a lot of good people on the trip. We rode a lot of good spots.
Ladies and gentlemen, Nathan Williams is on the horse.
Here we go. Just like that, ladies and gentlemen.
I don't know. Yeah, it's been really good. Thanks for inviting me.
So this is it. Had an amazing time on this trip. The whole crew was really good.
And there's no drama or any of that stuff. You know, we just had a good time. Everybody got along, laughed a lot, had a lot of fun.
There was a bit of a rail session directly across the street. Super fun, played a lot of games, jokes, you know, a lot of pranks went down, a lot of push-ups went down on the MINE game.
A little different than normal Road Fools. We didn't really travel as much as in past trips, but it was a good time.
It's the end of the trip, super fun, just everything I've ever expected out of coming on one of these trips, you know. Just the riding was insane, good crew to hang out with, and sweetness.
Justin dropped in on a quarter and jumped over a Domino's Pizza Man car.
He was a little worried about it, but then he saw that I made it way over and he was very excited.
I had an amazing trip. Yeah, just a little bum. My ankle was hurt the whole time. Hasn't really got much better. Rode on it anyways, which is not a good idea, but I mean, I had a blast regardless. Just good times. It's a dream come true.
partying and electrocuting each other.
It's like a lot of crazy quick.
Road fools.
No more police escorts or the high school welcome bands. I'm no lie detector. He's no bullshit talker, and we both know who knows what should be known to all the
right guys. There. Yo, look at that.
Hey, what's up? Just eating dinner.
Hi, I'm Nathan Williams. I'm 19 years. No, I'm not. I'm not 19.
The only donkey they'll be riding, boy, is the one wearing your shoes. Now they've heard it through the walls. I'm no lie detector. He's no bullshit talker, and we both know who knows what should be known to all the onlookers.
There's gotta be a better way to do this than take apart my bike.
I don't care if I'm the only one who's not paying.
That's six.
Seven.
Everybody's farting and they all think it's hilarious. They think it's funny. I don't have your bike, Martinez. Why do you always blame me? I don't have your bike. So violent.
It's not a party until the Gons is here. Now the Gons is here, the party's starting.
Down at the carport of a local library. I'm no lie detector. He's no bullshit talker, and we both know who knows what should be known to all the onlookers. I'm no lie detector. He's no bullshit talker.
This rocket is completely bent right now.
All the onlookers. I'm no lie detector. He's no bullshit talker, and we both know who knows what should be known to all the onlookers.
Trip was good. The funny moments is everyone playing the MI mind game. Yo, shut up.
Push up.
I'm not doing push-ups now.
You said it.
You serious?
Yeah, I'm serious.
You know what's